Pierre Robin sequencer syndrome is when kids are born with an abnormally small lower jaw, a larger than normal tongue for the size of the jaw, and sometimes cleft palate. About two-thirds of kids who are born with Pierre Robin sequence have a cleft palate. The diagnosis of Pierre Robin sequence is often made based on history and physical examination. Historical features such as difficulty breathing or stopping breathing during the night can occur. The other thing that we concentrate on is a child's ability to feed, because if a child can't feed, it's hard for them to grow. And the feeding and the breathing issues can go hand in hand. If your child has Pierre Robin sequence, our team may decide to order a number of tests. One of the tests is a polysomnogram or sleep study in which we will measure the level of oxygen that your child is getting while sleeping. This also gives us some information about what the brain is doing while your child's sleeping, as well as the heart and the lungs. Another important test to do is a microlaryngoscopy and bronchoscopy, which is a test in which we stick a very small fiber optic camera into the airway and watch your child breathe. This gives us a lot of information about the anatomy of the airway, which will help direct care as we move forward. The last test we might order is an X-ray of the head and neck, which will give us information about the anatomy of the jaw, as well as its size relative to other structures of the head and neck. Because there's a wide variety of patients who have Pierre Robin sequence, there's also a wide range of treatments. Most mild cases of Pierre Robin sequence can be treated with prone positioning alone. That's when a child sleeps facing downward. By sleeping facing downward, the base of the tongue is brought forward, which will allow them to breathe more easily. More moderate or severe cases of Pierre Robin sequence are treated with either tongue-lip adhesion, mandibular distraction, or a tracheostomy. Tongue-lip adhesion is when the undersurface of the tongue is sewn to the lower lip. This brings the tongue base forward and can be applied in moderate cases of Pierre Robin sequence. Mandibular distraction osteogenesis is a technique in which we actually elongate the abnormally small jaw. By bringing the chin point forward with this technique, it drags the tongue base forward to relieve airway obstruction. Our plastic surgery team has a tremendous amount of expertise in treating Pierre Robin sequence. We offer the full range of treatment modalities that are used throughout the United States and the world to treat this problem. If your child has Pierre Robin sequence, they may see a number of different specialists here at CHOP. Our team has an extensive experience with this, and in fact, we're one of the largest volume centers in the country. Our multidisciplinary team of experts creates a customized treatment plan for every child. And then we reevaluate as they continue to go through childhood and grow, so that at every time point, we optimize their outcome.